and choosing to spend your valuable time with me. I definitely appreciate that. So, what do we got going on here? I am currently not in my usual spot of Houston, Texas. I am, however... Nice. Just got me some tea here. I just brewed up this tea. It's got sea moss, bladderwrack, which is right there alone contains the 102 minerals that your body needs. But other than that, I've also got some burdock root in here, which is a great blood purifier, which is definitely beneficial. You know, it does other things than just purify the blood, which is the thing with most, you know, herbs, right? They have a multitude of benefits. So you might be using this herb for one thing, but then someone else could use it for a completely different thing. You know, it's just whatever you feel like. But then at the same time, you know, it's like, yeah, I'm using this to help, you know, purify me, give me some extra, you know, nutrition, right? And then along with the other two, it's just, oh, it's so potent. It's a very potent concoction right there, or a mixture, I should say, which I turned into a concoction by making a tea out of it. But back to a earlier point I was making, right? Me purifying my body, the blood, right? You know, giving it nutrients, you know, things that it needs to facilitate cleansing is very beneficial since I am on a 7-day water fast right now. So, as many of you know, we did the 2-week fast towards the beginning of the year, and we didn't go 2 weeks. We only went a week, and then we, you know, started working our way back into, you know, with the juices and the fruits and, you know, the other plethora of cooked foods out there, right? So, with this fast, I really wanted to go deep, you know? Personally, I'm still not sure if I want to do 7 days or if I want to go to 14 days, right? Because I've done a 7-day fast, you know, earlier in the year, but this is going to be like my second 7-day fast. And last time I was using coconut water, I was using the herbs, I was using regular water, but this time the difference with this fast, I kind of wanted to be a little bit more strict, you know, just straight water, right? Like people, you know, thousands of years ago, I'm pretty sure people were only fasting on water for the most part. Now, granted, a fast is a multitude of things, right? You can fast on juices, you can fast on fruit, you can do a dairy fast, right? You literally cut out all dairy for a week or two. And that is a type of fasting. But typically when people talk about fasting, they do mean on either water or juices or a dry fast where you go without either one of those. Oh man, so let me take a sip of this tea. Just really working on being present with myself, you know, feeling the body, you know, kind of trying to relax. While I was here with my girl, I was going to attempt, for those of you who know that I am a music producer as well as a rapper. So I used to only make my own music, but now I literally make, you know, the whole thing. Right? So not only do I write the lyrics, now I make the beats. You know, I've been working on mixing and mastering. I still have a long way to go before, you know, I'm able to do what many other people are able to do. And, you know, I could just pay them to do it. So that's kind of where I'm at, you know, as far as my music goes. It's just like, you can't be good at everything, you know? Even though I have been kind of mixing for a few years, but it's like, I don't know, there's just like some hidden tips or tricks or there's something that I don't know. So until I can figure out what that is, then it would probably be beneficial for me and someone else, right? You know, if I just outsource and pay them to mix my songs and my beats, that way it's just perfect every time, no matter if I play it on like the crappiest cell phone or the worst car speakers or the best cell phone and the best car speakers, it will sound beautiful everywhere. And that is something that is quite difficult to do if you know anything about mixing music. It's not easy as you would think it would be. It's like, hey, just make it sound good on your computer and that's going to translate everywhere. And I know this isn't a video about music, but for those of you who do like music, then that is for you. But also, what's in this tea? I have a little bit of a lymphatic tincture. So help clean the lymphatic system, help stimulate movement in that, help get that stuff out of me. I was gonna pee in a jar, and I actually wish I had that to show y'all in this video, but a beautiful thing to do, just to make sure that your organs of elimination are properly working, you know, like liver, kidneys, things like that, you want to pee in a jar. So I got my mason jar over there. It's got a little pee in it, but like like less than half a cup of pee. So it's really nothing to mention, but I mentioned it. Whatever, man. So, yeah, you want to make sure that you pee in a jar, right? Glass, jar, cup, doesn't really matter. You just want to pee in there, you know, a decent, like, if you can get a half a cup of urine in there, then that's perfectly fine, right? But you want to do that. You want to let that sit for about an hour. It should be good after an hour, right? Because you want to see the sediment in your urine, and it's kind of funny. I'm really feeling something going on right now. Hell yeah, let me take another sip of this tea. I want to feel it all, man. I want to feel that cleanse. But before I get sidetracked, you want to pee in a jar or a cup, you know, clear. And you want to let that sit for about an hour. And then after that hour, you want to see that sediment, which is filtered out through the urine. You want to see that, you know, kind of floating around at the bottom. It should be like some white specks, you know, depending on how clean you are, right? It just really depends. And then if you're doing, well, I mean, really anyone can do this, right? You don't have to be on a fast or, you know, in, you know, the process of a heavy detox to do this. Like, if you just got done eating a meal, you can literally go pee in a cup, let that sit for about an hour, and you should, after an hour, see some white specks floating around in there, right? That would tell you that you are properly filtering through your kidneys. Now, if you don't see that in there, I would suggest you go find some herbs. If I remember, I mean, you can use nettle, horsetail, freaking parsley, you know, cilantro helps a little bit with the kidneys. Like, there's so many different, you know, herbs, you know, that you can use to help stimulate, you know, your kidneys, help to clean those out, help to work on those to get those filtering properly. Because if you're not filtering out these different toxins that you get from eating the cooked foods and you get from, you know, the environmental toxins, right? The smog that comes out of the back end of these cars, right? The chemtrails and all these different things in the air, right? If you're not cleansing yourself of these environmental toxins, they're just gonna build up, build up, build up. Next thing you know, you've got some disease that they can label on you, and they can feed you drugs, and you'll believe that you need these drugs because I don't know why, you know, in your mind, you'll be like, I don't know why this is happening to me. But it's because most of us live in a very toxic environment that's not really conducive to health. Sad thing, right? It's it's so beautiful, right? These cities. And like, I live in Houston, right? So I live in a big city, you know? And I'm really feeling this go through me. Like, I'm really feeling this go through me right now. That's crazy. Yeah, I kind of thought, like, today, you know, I want to kind of go in on the teas. Because so far, the first 2 days of the fast, I've only been doing water. Like I said, I wanted to do a more strict water fast this time to, like, really, you know, put my body through something. You know, I'm, like, not too crazy, but, you know, just to kind of, you know, really get my body in that mode of cleansing itself. So yeah, I haven't done any coconut water, and as I've said, you know, numerous times before, I'm a big fan of fasting on coconut water. Honestly, every fast that I've done for the past 6 months, I don't like six months, every fast I've done, I have done on coconut water. Maybe not like only coconut water, but I have definitely used coconut water while I was fasting. You know, at least if I can, like 2 liters a day. You definitely want to make sure you're hydrating. That way you're flushing the intestines, flushing the colon. You're really getting those fluids in there to help wash you from the inside. You know, that internal shower that most people neglect. And given the fact that our bodies are about, you know, 70% water when we are properly hydrated, right? Given that fact that your body is supposed to be made out of that much water, you know, you've got water in the muscles and the veins, just all throughout you, right? So you definitely want to stay hydrated. And as most, you know, experienced people will tell you, you want to be getting at least a gallon of fluids a day. In my opinion, I think women are able to get away with a little less, maybe a liter and a half at the most less. But for the most part, you definitely want to be making sure that you're getting enough fluids. Now, if you're a bigger girl, you know, nothing against you bigger girls. A lot of y'all are cute. So, like, don't let, you know, beautiful on the inside and the out. Let me say that, right? Because most of y'all are. Like, just given my experience in life, you know, that's a very true thing. So, and even if you're a bigger dude, right? Like, hey, do your thing, bro. But, you know, definitely the bigger you are, you want to make sure you're getting more fluids, in my opinion, because you've kind of got a little bit more to work with, right? And we want to make sure that everything is being properly hydrated, right? Because when things are properly hydrated, when they're properly oxygenated, you know, when you're getting those minerals that you need, then the system just works as it should, right? So, as far as I can go back kind of to what's in my tea, right? So I've got these lymphatic tinctures. Now, the first time I actually ever did a tincture was from R Botanicals. It was from R Botanicals, which is Dr. Robert Morse. It's kind of like where he sells his tinctures and his different formulas. So I had the lymphatic tincture, and then I got the kidney gallbladder, and I use those, and I like, you can feel it, right? When you're using these different tinctures, you can really feel it, you know, working throughout you, kind of like I feel this right now. I think it might be because it could be because I'm on day 3 of a fast, and it could also be because I put it in this tea. That way, when you drink things like tea and, you know, you warm up the water, it's able to go inside of you and, like, cut through that gunk and that, you know, that garbage and all that different stuff that's just kind of sitting on the inside of you. It's able to do that a lot better than if you were to use, say, cold water or, you know, room temperature water. And, like, yeah, I'm definitely feeling this right now. Like, definitely, like, all over, really. So that's pretty cool to, for that to be happening in live time, you know? So that right there kind of, you know, the light bulb, because I have a light bulb here, because not the best light in here. I mean, I could turn that light on, but I kind of wanted to have like a little ambiance, you know, like a little subtle feel, since I am talking about, you know, fasting. So yeah, I just have the light bulb here to give me a little bit of extra light. I guess you could say this is my key light. For those of you who know about photography, videography, I'm not really going to get into it. You know what I'm talking about. But, yeah. I wanted to have the candle going on back here or somewhere in the background, you know, to give it a little bit of extra, you know, feel. But, I couldn't find a lighter anywhere. And, yeah, I could have put, like, a paper towel to the stove, but I didn't want to start burning stuff in here. I'm like, whatever, man. Just turn the camera on, make the video, talk to the people, right? Let them know what you're doing. Let them know what's going on. So I'm really feeling this tea, you know? I mean, it doesn't taste bad. For any of you who've tried sea moss or bladderwrack, which are both different types of seaweed, or even burdock root, you know? Like, more so the seaweeds, you know, the sea moss and the bladderwrack. So, yeah, this camera only likes to do segments of about 15 minutes. So, yeah, cut off. But, yeah, as far as the sea moss and the bladderwrack, those two have, you know, that more natural, salty sea taste to them. A lot of people will say fishy, but it's like the fish, they don't taste like fish. The fish tastes like the sea, you know? It's that real salty, nutrient dense taste that you get from the sea and different things around there. You know, aquatic plants and stuff like that. Very nutritional. Like I said, sea moss has 82 of the 102 minerals that your body, 92 of the 102 minerals that your body needs. Bladderwrack has the other 10, right? I mean, that's not all it has, but, you know, the 10 that, you know, sea moss doesn't have, you can pick up the slack with, you know, the bladderwrack. And then you add that burdock root there to further help cleanse you and give you a little bit of extra nutrition, you know, vitamins, minerals. It's just like, it's such a powerful combination. And I'm a testament right here, you know. This is probably about 2 cups right here. So I'll definitely probably end up having, honestly, like 3 more of these today. Because I'm actually really liking how that goes down, you know. So I'll do this. After I end the video, I'll probably make another cup of tea. Cup of tea. Then I'll go ahead and I'll do, because usually what I've been doing is I get my gallon in, so I use the mason jars. So mason jars is going to be a liter or a quart of fluids. So what I just do, I'll fill it up, then I'll put my lymphatic tincture in there. I'll put a ginkgo tincture in there, so ginkgo biloba is what it's called, right there. I have it pulled up on my laptop, so I know how to pronounce it. But yeah, the ginkgo biloba, and that it's good for a multitude of things, you know, as are all herbs. You know, it's good for heart health, circulation, reduce anxiety, can help with depression, PMS. It's got antioxidants in there, so it's like just so many different things, right? Me, I'm using it for, you know, the antioxidants, the circulation, brain, the heart health. Those are more things that I'm concerned with. 'Cause I have had some issues in the past, mainly. I'm not really sure 'cause I haven't gone to a doctor. So, you know, this is anecdotal, I guess. But yeah, a little less than a year ago, but last March, I went on a 5-day juice fast. For those of y'all who haven't heard the story, I went on a 5-day juice fast and I was smoking some cannabis, yes, marijuana, yes, weed, right? I was smoking that every day that I was on the fast, and I was having negative reactions literally every time that I would smoke it. But for some reason, I didn't connect that it was the fact that I was on this fast. You know, I was cleansing myself. I wasn't really, you know, it's like when you stop putting solid foods into the body, your body starts to act different. For those of you who have been on, you know, who've done fasting before multiple times, right? So you really have, you know, a wide knowledge base, right? When you stop putting solid foods in your body and you only go to liquids, your body starts to react a little bit differently, right? Now, if you're on a juice fast, right, you can literally go from doing a week-long juice fast right back to eating, you know, like solid foods the next day, right? Because with the juice fast, you're still getting, you know, a lot of those, you know, vitamins, minerals, you're getting the enzymes, you're getting the antioxidants, you're getting soluble fiber. So you're still getting a lot of the things that your body needs, right? So you could, you know, as soon as it's over, I mean, because that's what I did. As soon as it was over, you know, you just jump back on to cooked foods. Now, when you're doing a water fast like I'm doing, you need to take it a little bit slower, right? So typically they say if you go on a 7-day water fast, right, you're going to need about 7 days to recover. Now, honestly, in my opinion, you won't need the full 7 days. But if you want to take it, you know, if you want to really go slow back into it, then that's fine. There's nothing wrong with that. Me personally, I plan on when I break this fast. Of course, I'm not fully sure yet. I don't know if I want to do another 7 days. Like I said, I'm really just going to have to see how I feel after this first 7 days. And right now I'm on day 3. So today, really, my body should be finishing off any of the glucose stores that are within my body, you know, that sugar that it likes to run off of. And I would say by the end of today, you know, the start of tomorrow, my body should kick into ketosis, and then it should be running off those ketones, and then it should start the process of, you know, breaking down the parts of the body that are weak, you know, and starting to, you know, cannibalize those, break those down for nutrition, for energy, and really start to dig into the true detox, the real healing, right? So for any of y'all out there, it's cool, you know, say if you're starting out, right? It's definitely okay to do a 24-hour fast, a 36-hour fast, you know, 2-day fast, 3-day fast, but you have to realize this. Your body is running off of glucose. It's running off of sugar because that is the main source of energy that the human body likes. You know, a lot of people don't want to admit that, but it's kind of what is the truth, you know? So your body likes sugar. You know, it doesn't matter how much people are out here talking about, oh, sugar's bad for you. Like, you know, you really don't want that much sugar. And then they have the audacity to blame the fruits, right? Which is natural fructose, which has literally never hurt anyone, right? You know, I mean, maybe if you use it in a bad application, right? Maybe if you have certain intolerances from all the garbage that's still stuck inside your colon, stuck inside your intestines. And really, that's where these different food intolerances come from. Say a gluten intolerance, or people who can't eat nuts, or, you know, people who are lactose intolerant, right? Most of the time, that is because in your younger years, right? Or say maybe your parents had an intolerance, you know, more so the mom, right? Because everybody gets their immune system from their mother. So if your mom's sick, not doing so well, when she gives life to you, when she births you, then you are literally going to get her immune system. So yes, you'll be able to do a little bit better for a time than her, but at the end of the day, you know, once you start putting in those cooked foods and the animal products and the dairy and all these different things, you know, when you're not sprouting your grains, nuts, seeds, beans, then it's just, it's just gonna build up, build up, build up, and next thing you know, you're sick your whole life, right? And that's what one of the reasons why people are getting sicker and sicker and sicker as time goes on, right? Because you have sick adults who give life to sick children, right? And then, you know, the dad's sick, so you get, you know, part of him. And then the mom's sick, so you get, you know, part of her. So you got two sick people making a seemingly healthy child in the beginning when it's born. But then, you know, you put it on the same diet, and, you know, you have it around the same toxic environments, right, as you are in. And then it's just going to not turn out very good for that kid, you know? Now, if you want to go ahead and give your child fruits and vegetables and, you know, sprouted grains and seeds and stuff like that, then it'll be all fine, right? You know, if you work with your kid, you know, to, you know, feed it things that are going to clean it out, right? To make sure that, you know, its colon is good, you know, the different organs are good. You know, you want to make sure you're putting stuff in there that's going to flow easily through the intestines, not get stuck up in there, not going to, you know, be real acidic and toxic for the body, you know. It's like, it's just best, right? And of course, you know, if you're eating the improper foods, then of course you're not going to feed your kid the right stuff. So it's like, you know, it all starts with you, right? It all starts with you. That's why I'm fully of the belief, man, because I'm on the journey right now to becoming a fruitarian. Well, not a fruitarian, but a raw foodist. I do believe in fruitarianism. Vegetables are still good, though, but the highest vibrational fruits, or the highest vibrational foods on the planet, the highest nutrition bearing foods on the planet, right, the foods that are going to cause an alkaline ash or an alkaline byproduct once it's all broken down, once your cells start to, you know, break stuff down, just the best foods for your body are going to be the fruits, right? Now, if you're not the cleanest person, that could lead to some problems. It could, right? Because that's going to be a good detox in itself, right? If you're eating, you know, I'd say, you know, every meal you're eating 1 to 3 servings of fruit, and I'd probably say closer to 2. I mean, depending on what you're having. Like, if I was gonna have a meal, say, with apples, I would try to at least get 4 apples in, you know, and have that be a meal. If you were just going to have just that, or if I was gonna have oranges, I'd probably try to have like 4 or 5 oranges. Now, if you're gonna do like grapes, then yeah, you can do like 40 to 60 grapes and that be a meal, right? Now, of course, this is if you're trying to go, you know, the fruitarian route, or if you're trying to do like a detox, right? You could honestly, like, probably the perfect meal plan in my decision, if you want to do 3 meals a day, would be start your morning off with juice around 12, 1 o'clock, you know, that way you can get a nice fast in, right? That way you can continue that process of cleaning yourself after you wake up, right? So you can do that. You can start the day off with juice or coconut water. It really depends. It's really up to you. I mean, honestly, you could do 1 liter of coconut water, and then you could do 1 liter of some juice, like the sunrise juice that I made in a previous video. About 2 videos ago, I made that. I'll put it down in the description, if I remember. So hopefully I watch this whole thing while I'm editing it. That way I can put that down and have that down in the description for y'all to see a type of juice that you can make. Now with that, I put apples in there. I put oranges in there. I had some ginger. I had some limes. And yeah, that was it. Like a real simple juice. You know, you have the apples, which are very astringent, have a lot of liquid in there. Then you have the oranges with that citric acid, which is very good at going in there and breaking down the garbage inside of the intestines and the colon, as well as being very stimulating for your lymphatic system, as are all other, you know, kind of citrusy fruits. You know, you have your lemons, you've got limes, you've got the oranges. Grapes are very good at cleaning your lymphatic system as well. I love grapes. Honestly, once I break this fast, I really think I'm probably going to do 2 to 3 days on just grape, lime, orange juice. And oh my goodness, right there, you have essentially right there the three most powerful fruits that will help cleanse the lymphatic system. And not only that, it'll go through there and clean out all the toxins, all the buildup of, you know, that comes from eating the improper foods, you know, that gets left in the liver and the kidneys and the intestines and the colon. Just go in there and really cut through all of that and help to flush all that out. But then, like I said, you want to make sure you're filtering, right? So you want to make sure the kidneys are working. You want to make sure the liver's good. You want to really be mindful of those organs of elimination, right? Because if you start to cleanse yourself and, you know, these toxins are going to want to get out because you essentially have shooken up the beehive, right? You threw a rock at it and, you know, like they're everywhere now. So when you're really going in there and you're really cutting through that garbage that's inside of you, you really want to make sure that you are able to filter that stuff out. So you want to be taking herbs for the kidneys. You want to be taking herbs for the liver. Okay? You want to be making sure that you're stimulating the lymphatic system, because that's the purpose of the lymphatic system. It's really your immune system, right? If your lymphatic system is flowing the way it should, it's going to pick up all those toxins that are in the body, and it's just gonna get them out. Just gonna get them out, simple as that. But if you've been eating a lot of acidic foods, if you've been eating a lot of foods that lack moisture, haven't been sprouted, don't have the enzymes inside of them, okay? All these foods that create an acidic byproduct once it's broken down in the body, that byproduct acid is going to be hot, it's going to be slow moving, right? So it ends up going to the lymphatic system. Now you've just got this hot, stagnant stuff sitting inside of, you know, the lymphatic system, not moving, right? You just got all these toxins in here just chilling, essentially, right? And then once you get backed up in your lymphatic system, then it starts to go everywhere, right? So your face starts to break out, right? That's your body trying to get rid of the garbage inside of you, right? So if you have like real bad acne, you should probably, I would say, as a place to start, and I know I was talking about the meal plan, but I'll get back to that in a second. It's just how my mind works, man. It's like, I'm here and I'm there, and you know, I can really go all over with it. There's just so many thoughts, right? So much knowledge. And you know, I'm not one of these people who's like, oh, here's a whiteboard and here's point number one, point two, point three. Like, I don't care anything about that, right? If you want to sit here and get the knowledge, then you're going to sit here and you're going to get the knowledge, right? But typically the only people who really care, right, are going to do that. Only people who are really inquisitive about these different things, healing, are going to even sit here past like 2 minutes and even be listening to me, even be paying me any mind, you know, paying mind. That's funny. But you definitely want to make sure that you are taking herbs that are going to help your kidneys, your liver, help move the lymph. Because like I said, if you're not people who have a bunch of acne, people who get dandruff, you know, you're getting all these different bumps and stuff on you. That is your body trying to cleanse itself of all the garbage that's inside of it. This stuff is not normal. Well, in this society, it's been made normal. It's been very normalized, you know. Advertisements and, you know, the drugs, the different drugs that people are taking. I'm not talking about recreational, right? I'm not talking about weed. I'm not talking about cocaine. I'm not talking about none of that stuff, you know, your beer, your wine, right? I'm talking about these pharmaceutical companies, okay? The trillion-dollar industry that is pharmaceutical drugs, right? I'm talking about those kinds of drugs. I'm not going to get into any specifics, but you know exactly what I'm talking about, right? One thing I could say, though, is if you're on birth control, there's definitely healthier, better ways to do that, right? So many issues arise when it comes to birth control, and I'm not going to get into it, but so many issues when it comes to birth control that you really should be wary of it, you know? And that's all I'm going to say about that. But for anyone who wants to start on a detox program, I would say what you want to do is, first of all, you would want to cut out the dairy products, right? Just cut it out. Just get rid of it. You don't need it, right? You can cut that out. You could go a step further and cut out eggs if you want. I mean, you don't have to. I mean, dairy is already doing a lot of benefit for you right there anyway. So you can cut out the dairy. If you can, I'd say limit meat to 1 to 2 meals a day. If anything, start your day off, like when you break your fast, breakfast, break fast, it's literally right there, you know? Like there's so much knowledge hidden inside of words and just different things, right? That people aren't seeing because you're not taught to see it, right? There's just a lot. There's a lot of knowledge literally just right here in front of our faces every day that we just don't see because we've been programmed to not see. We've been programmed to think a certain way and all fast food is super good. Like you can eat fast food 3 meals a day and it's like, whoa, you're gonna be like super healthy, dude. It's like, you know, when you talk about like a raw food diet or, you know, fruitarian or vegan even, right? It's like, oh, where do you get your protein from? It's like, yeah, because when you went to KFC for that bucket of chicken, I doubt you were really worried. I doubt you were really checking the back, like, yo, like, how much protein's in this bucket, you know? No one cares. Like, no one cares. You know, it's only when you get rid of animal products, when you get rid of these protein structures, which are hard to break down in the body, which, you know, causing acidic ash when it's broken down. The body creates an acidic byproduct, which is toxic for the body, which puts your body through more stress than it needs. And also it can get to the amino acids, right? Which are available in all fruits, all vegetables, essentially everything, really. So it's crazy. It's like, you know, you could eat a steak, but you don't have to. But, you know, everyone's working at their level of understanding, of knowledge, of consciousness. So at the end of the day, it's like, it's whatever, man. Like, you can do whatever you want to do. Just realize what you're doing. And then, of course, you know, the more that your body, the more that you think about these things, the more that you align your cells with the knowledge, right? It's like you won't even be able to, like, eat a lot of this stuff out here, you know? I mean, of course, the mind is powerful, right? If you're like, hey, I know that this freaking cheeseburger is probably going to be not the best thing for me to eat, but, right, like, yo, I have a super positive mindset about it, right? Like, I'm just going to do it, right? you'll possibly be okay, right? The placebo effect, man. The power of the mind is so great, right? Literally anything can be done off of the power of the mind, right? People have healed themselves. People have destroyed themselves off of the power of the mind alone. No change in diet, no extra help from drugs, like no counseling, no nothing, right? Just straight mental power, right? And of course, the cleaner that you are, you know, the stronger that you are, not only in your, you know, thinking capabilities, you know, but just being able to attract things to your life that are beneficial, you know, because you'll be cleaner, your frequency will be such higher, you'll be vibrating, you know, like, you know, like when you eat like the gods, you know, you become, right? Most people aren't ready for that one, but, you know, hey man, if you still need religion, if that's something that really helps you, and that's the thing, like, a lot of people aren't ready for the higher vibrational foods, right? Like the fruits and the vegetables, you know, people just aren't ready for that, right? Because they've lived their whole lives, you know, oh, I need religion and I need something outside of myself to save me, right? When really, it's like, yo, we are. Like, if you really know what God is and if you really understand, right? If you know the difference between scripture, which is written by man, and I'm not getting on any specific religion here, I'm talking about all of y'all. So, you know, let's keep that understood, right? But if you got these scriptures, which are written by man, okay, and then you have the living word, right? There's a difference, right? The living word is what's actual factual, right? You got all this stuff that man says. It's like, oh, it's okay to eat animals and it's okay to, you know, eat all these different things. But then when you look at it, it's like majority of the people coming down with these different forms of dis-ease, and you know, most of the people who get like sick and stuff like that, not to say that people who don't eat animal products don't get sick. And there's the train. There's a lot of trains here. There's literally a train track right there. Like, less than a block away. Probably, it'd take me about 30 seconds to walk to the train track. That's how close it is. But anyway, it seems like it's not going that far. Yes. So, but yeah, it's like, yo, most of the people, especially the people who I watch, right? These raw foodists, okay, they're not getting sick. Like, yeah, they might get some cold and flu-like symptoms, but that's your body fighting off whatever it has to fight off, right? So it creates more mucus, so you get the runny nose, and you're coughing up the, you know, the mucus, right? And it's like your body is actively fighting something, okay? So it's gonna do its job. So it needs you to do your job and get out of your freaking head. Oh my gosh, I'm so, I don't like this runny nose. I don't like how I'm feeling right now, right? You don't like the healing process. That's what you're afraid of. You're afraid to heal. You know, we've been raised in a dying, sick society. Like, that's just what this is. That's what the world has become, right? And the people with all the money, right? The people running the corporations, that's what they want. Otherwise, they're not going to make a whole lot of money, right? But anyway, you know, it's like you got these people who are eating a raw diet or who are eating, you know, mostly fruits and vegetables. They're not getting sick like that. Like, you don't hear about these people coming down with all these different diseases, right? And I know it seems like, oh, veganism, you know, raw foods, it's just like a new age fad, essentially, right? But this stuff's been going on for thousands of years, man, since the beginning. Literally since the beginning, right? Literally, like, we've only been cooking our foods for about 10% of human existence, right? So for about 90% of our existence, we've been eating raw foods. And people want to say that you can't survive off of raw foods, right? And I'm not a raw foodist yet, but I definitely am going to be, I am going to be a raw foodist by the end of this year. That is what I want to do because I know that is the best thing to do. And then I came across the Essene Gospel of Peace. I mean, I've heard John Rose talk about it, which that is a great mentor who I've had. And then I've heard Dr. Robert Morse has talked about it. The Life Regenerator has talked about it. Luke Rona. It's like all these people, man. And when you read the Essene Gospel of Peace, right? When you read that book, it's like, yo, literally thousands of years ago, they were telling people to not cook their foods because you're going to cook the life force out of it. You're going to kill it. It is now essentially dead. And you shouldn't be eating dead. Like, life is life. Death equals death. You eat dead foods, you are death. You are dying on the inside, right? You have garbage inside of you. You have trash inside of you, which is toxic. It's acidic, okay? Lacking in nutrition, right? That is what cooked food is. And it tastes good. It tastes real fucking good. I'm not afraid to say it, right? Yo, give me a hot pizza. Yo, give me a hot pizza. I mean, I've been doing the plant-based thing, but back in the day, dude, like, give me some good old chicken, you know, fried. Yeah. But yo, give me some fried chicken, or you know what? Give me the pizza, give me the wings, give me the ranch. Ooh, a little bit of honey mustard. So I can, oh my gosh. Right? Third day of a fast, right? Oh my goodness, he shouldn't be doing that to himself. I'll be okay. I really will be. It's like, yeah, I've been thinking about food a little bit, and it's like, I see limes there, there's some bananas. I mean, there's my buddy Monroe right here. So it's like, gotta feed him. So, you know, I try, or we try, me and my girl, when we do feed him, to give him the best, and the air just came on. Don't really know how that's gonna affect the video, but here we are. But definitely when we feed him, when it's not, you know, the little pellets, right? And of course, like, we get him like the best, like a organic, like very nutritionally dense dog food. So yeah, we're not buying him that regular stuff from the freaking wherever, right? Purina or Puppy Chow or none of those people. No. Like, we get him like the top quality stuff. Because, I mean, if you're gonna be eating this food, which is like, eh, I would prefer him, you know, eating like real meat. Like, you know, we go and we freaking just let him roam around, essentially. I mean, honestly, it's like, I don't know, you know. Preferably, what I would love to have for him is if we could stay close to a farm that, you know, they process their own meat, and we could be like, hey, we'll go over there and be like, yo, let's get, you know, let me get some beef from my buddy, right? Let me get some beef, let me get some chicken, you know? Let me get some food that was just butchered, you know, organic, biodynamic, you know, no antibiotics, no drugs that they're feeding these animals, all right? If you are eating animals, they're feeding them drugs. Antibiotics, okay, they're feeding them all kinds of stuff. GMO soy, wheat, corn, right? So it's like, oh, I don't eat GMOs, but you're eating animals who most likely were fed GMOs. So it's like they're literally created out of GMOs. But yo, the video is about to turn off, so I'm just gonna beat it. So I didn't beat the video, but here we are, right? This is a pretty long one, right? But honestly, I love it, right? This is what I like. I like sitting here, and I like talking, and I like, you know, just having a conversation, right? getting these ideals out. I think that's very awesome, dope. It's freaking wonderful. And I mean, hey, even like, there's people like me, because I'm the type of person who I'll go to someone's channel if I really like them, and I'll sit through, like, I will be excited for their hour-long video, right? I'm like, yo, I'm trying to sit here, I'm trying to listen to this person speak for an hour, I'm trying to gain that wisdom, I'm trying to really, because you got these people out here making these 5-10 minute videos, you know, 2 minute videos, and it's like, I can't read, like, you know, you're reading off the whiteboard, right? So you got these bullet points that you're trying to hit, you know, it's like, oh, I'm gonna cut it and then I'm gonna come back in. You know, like, nothing against people who do that, right? I think I have a few videos like that, you know, back in the day. You know, but personally, I like the whole drawn out format, I guess you could say. Not drawn out, but like, just like easy, you know, conversation. Like, we're just here, you know, two friends, right? Having a good time, having a conversation. You know, no need to rush, like, we got time. But yeah, man, there's just a lot going on, man, and it's like, people really think that they can't live a healthy life without cooking their foods. They think they can't live a healthy life without eating the flesh of a dead animal, because that's what it is. And most people don't want to think about that. Most people are so detached, right? Like, most people are so detached. Like, I haven't been 100% good on my plant-based journey. Like, I've gone back and eaten meat before. I know it's a dead animal. Whatever, right? It's like, hey, this is what I want to do, right? So it's like, you know, a lot of people aren't ready to do that. It's like, yo, I don't want to think about this animal being dead. I don't want to think about it having a life. I don't want to think about it not wanting to die. Like, I don't want to think about none of that, right? That's where people are at, right? Living in the illusion, living in the lie. And I mean, if that's something that you want to do, then, like, hey, it's your life, right? Live it up, you know? But me, I think that's a little bit weak, a little bit built out of fear. Because I think a lot of people, they know, right? They, even if they don't really have, like, all the details and every little piece of the raw food puzzle, I think they really do know that eating a diet predominantly fruits and vegetables is healthier than anything else. It's just flat out healthier, you know? But what else could I touch on? I went through a lot of things in this video, right? And I don't know how long this video is, but here we are. Yeah, so I still got this tea here. It's not warm anymore. Got a little of those herbs down at the bottom. But yeah, this is day 3 of the fast. Now tomorrow, like I said, I should begin later tonight. Tomorrow my body should, you know, kick into ketosis and really start to break down the weaker parts of my body. So, like I said, for those of y'all who go on a fast 3 days or less, you're not really doing, like, a great, like, it is good. Like, it's still good to, you know, give your body time to rest, you know, give your liver, your kidneys, you know, time to rest, give your body that extra energy, because we use about 80% of the energy every day just to digest food, right? So digestion is a big part of the energy that we use throughout the day. So with that being said, once you go on a solid food vacation, then your body doesn't have to work so hard to break down all that food, you know, protein to amino acids, carbs to sugar, fats to fatty acids. You don't have to work so hard to break all that down. So you've got a lot of energy to play around with, right? With that, you can go ahead and cleanse the body, heal the body, you know? But, like I said, you're still going to have sugar inside of you, right? you know, you're still gonna have those glucose stores or those stores of sugar, which are going to be able to give your body energy when you do a shorter fast like that. So once you do 3 days, you're probably still going to be running off of those sugar stores. But once you get to that day 4, day 5, day 6, day 7, and you know, however long you are doing your cleanse for, that is, my ear just kind of popped. But that is when you really get into a deeper cleaning, right? That's what I'm looking for. I'm looking for that deeper cleaning. That way I can heal, you know, the issues that are going on with me over here. That way I can heal anything else that's going on in the body, you know. I can, you know, make sure the kidneys are going good, make sure the liver is going good. I can make sure my system is running properly as it should be. So, after today, what do we got? We got 4, 5, 6, 7. So, honestly, we started this fast on Monday, so it's going to end on Monday, you know, Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, today's Wednesday, so, and then Thursday, Friday, Saturday, Sunday, so, then when Monday comes back around and it is day 8, then I'm going to break the fast. I plan on, like I said, I plan on breaking the fast. Well, okay, because my girl, she goes to school on Mondays, so she leaves, and right now we're, this is where she goes to school, out here, and, yeah, she's actually at school right now, but, yeah, so she goes to school on Mondays, so she'll leave, so, yeah, we're gonna have to go to the farmer's market on Sunday, and get a bunch of grapes, bunch of oranges, because like I said, I want to do a 2 to 3 day fast. I want to do a 2 to 3 day fast on juices, right? And you could just buy some juice from the store. I think, personally, I don't know, right? Because it's like, yeah, it costs a little bit more than I would want to pay. But at the same time, I've juiced plenty of fruits, plenty of vegetables, and I know it takes a good amount of fruit. You can easily, trying to do, like, if you just say go to different stores and stuff like that, or the farmer's market even, you could easily spend up to $40 a day just trying to juice like a gallon a day, you know? And sometimes you might not even get that gallon, right? So it's like, you know, but across from the farmer's market that we go to is like kind of like a warehouse setup where they have big boxes of fruit, right? Like, we've gone there before and we've got giant box of grapes, cucumbers, limes, freaking oranges, apples, grapefruit, like just so much fruit and vegetables, so much good produce, like literally so much, right? Like, you can easily, like, 2 boxes you could juice for like a week. Like, there's so much, you know? And I haven't tested that out yet, but I plan on doing so, right? But yeah, I want to break my fast with doing about 2 to 3 days worth of just juice. Then I'll probably take some, you know, some supplemental powders, like the sea moss, bladderwrack, and burdock root powder that I made, which I plan on making a video about that in the future. Show y'all how you can make your own powders at home. You don't have to go to the store and buy their powders, but you can actually buy some high quality ingredients online, or if you have some herbal shops in your town, you can go there. You can just buy the herbs. Like, yeah, it'll cost a little bit more up front, but it will last you longer. So, you know, it's like, you gotta really think about it, you know? It's like, I could buy from here, you know, or I could buy from here, you know, and then I don't have to pay for really the packaging and all that stuff, and I will get more out of it. So, it really just depends what you want. And then as another, you know, point to touch on with that is that a lot of people just want convenience, right? They just want it quick, fast, and in a hurry. So, like, yeah, you can easily go to someone who's already processed it, packaged it up, looking nice, got the serving size on the back, and bam, it's all ready to go, you know? But if you're like me, someone who wants to get into, and someone who has been getting into the process of, like, doing everything myself, like, we, like, over the past year, you know, and even back in 2018, we've been, me and my girl, we've been making our own breads, like any snacks that we want. You know, we've been making cakes. She made a raw pie last year, like mangoes, dates, cashews, just like a beautiful pie, honestly. And probably what I'm gonna get her to do is to make another one of those once we break our fast. Probably not within like the first 4 to 5 days, but you know, day 6, day 7, you know, after the fast is over, if I am not still doing, you know, kind of some fasting work, then yeah, we'll just have to see about that. Because like I said, I kind of want to go 14 days on just the water fast. Not fully sure if I will do that. If I don't do that, I'm going to strongly consider doing a week on just juicing. So I'll do a juice feast for a week. I would love to do a juice feast for longer than that, and I will most likely definitely be doing that later on in the year. I would love to do, you know, 1 to 2 months on just juices. And really, because when I did the 5 days on juices, it was amazing because I only did 1/2 gallon a day. Now you should do 1 gallon a day. That's gonna work for most people, especially if you know, you got a job and kids and you're moving around. Like, you're gonna need that energy, right? You're gonna need those nutrients. And if you're getting 1 gallon of juice a day, you really don't have to worry about nutrients, because it's like, I don't care what anyone tries to say, there are way more nutrients inside of a piece of fruit than there are in a piece of meat. Like, I don't know how you can really try to debate that, but a lot of people will. So, like, anyway, it's like, that's the thing though. Like, if you just eat enough fruits, vegetables until you're full, you're gonna be perfectly fine. Like, you are going to be good. Like, you don't have to worry about any deficiencies. You don't have to worry about none of that stuff, right? That we've been programmed to think, okay? Because the fruits and the vegetables is really all we need. And like I said before, I know the cooked foods is wonderful. It really is. But you don't need it to survive. You just make the choice that you want to. And that's a lot of thing that people can't really accept, wrap their heads around. They're afraid to admit that life is just a choice, right? We choose everything. We attract everything in our life. If you have some type of sickness or disease, you attracted that to yourself, right? We attract everything, right? So if you just do things that attract better things, right? You know, it's like you're eating dead animals, right? It's like, you know, it's like, let's bring it back to that, you know? It's like you're eating dead animals, man. What did you expect, you know? Of course, you know, everyone you see on TV, they eat animals, and everyone you've ever known eats animals. So it's like, we're programmed. A lot of people are programmed, don't even know it, man. Don't even know it. But if I don't do an extra 7 days on this water fast, then I would love to do 7 days juicing. But if I don't do that as well, like I said, I'll just break the fast. The first 2-3 days I'll do strictly fruit and vegetable juice, and then I'll work my way up, you know, back into the fruits. I'll eat fruits for probably 2 to 3 days, and then, you know, I can work my way back into you know, the cooked foods. But, you know, you want to take it slow, right? You want to have a gradual transition when you do these kinds of things, right? What else could I talk about possibly in this video? I mean, I've gone over essentially everything that there is to go over, right? Ah, that is the thing. That is the last thing that I actually did want to touch on. But first, I actually am sitting next to a box of coconuts, which normally when I do a fast, I'd be tearing these bad boys up, right? But on this fast, I wanted to do a more strict water fast. No lime, no coconuts. This is day 3 and I just started to drink the tea, right? So the tea is the herbs, right? So whenever you go on a fast, you want to be using the herbs, right? You want to be stimulating those organs of elimination. If you have anything that's wrong with you, if you want to work on your brain or your lungs or whatever, you definitely want to be taking certain herbs that are going to facilitate, you know, cleansing and healing of those. Last video. Last cut, whatever. But yeah, whenever you're on a fast, you definitely, doesn't matter if you're doing a, well, if you're doing a dry fast, then you shouldn't be eating or drinking anything because it's dry. So yeah, you're not using herbs on a dry fast. So I definitely would not recommend that to anyone, but like someone who's already done 30 to 60 days worth of fasting prior to that. But yeah, dry fasting is very beneficial, good for your liver and your kidneys to, you know, get those working properly if they're not already, or to just help clean those out, you know, and help to get those going, you know, good, right? But whenever you're doing a water fast or a juice feast, I would definitely be mindful of the herbs, right? Definitely take those herbs. Don't be afraid to take the herbs, you know? Usually what I found out is when you use herbs from, like, so say like I go to Sprouts, right? That's where I get a lot of my tinctures from these days because, you know, I'm trying to save a little bit of money, right? Usually I would go to R Botanicals, but, you know, just trying to save a little bit, even though I know, you know, R Botanicals is going to be better, you know, it's wildcrafted, which means it's organic, you know, it's literally out in nature, and you just go out in nature, you know, in the wild, where it's been crafted, and you go, you know, you pick the herbs, and then you make the tincture from it. The battery's gonna end soon, but, so kind of to wrap this up, enemas. The last thing that I want to touch on is enemas, right? So every day that you do a fast, you want to do an enema because you have your body cleaning. You have your body trying to get rid of these toxins, right? And you definitely want to make sure that you can facilitate that by getting the water up in there, cleaning out the colon, right? Cleaning out the colon. And making sure that you're able to get the garbage that's piling up, you want to make sure you're getting that out of you, right? So I just started doing an enema. I want to say last Thursday is when I did my first enema. And at this point, we're on day 3. So I've done an enema. I did an enema Thursday. I did it Friday. I'm pretty sure I did one Saturday. And then I did one for the past 2 days. And so every day I'm going to do one. And, you know, more and more stuff's going to come out of me. Surprising, right? But, yeah, I just got, like, a cheap one from, you know, the store. Cost, like, less than $3. But, yeah, other than that, I think, you know, I was against enemas for a long time, you know. But, honestly, seeing what came out of me, I'm a believer now. So This battery is low. I don't know how much time I've got left. I've literally used all the charge in this battery. So with that being said, I'm the Wavvy One. I hope you enjoyed this video. I hope you were able to gain something from this video, from my, you know, jumping all over the place. You know, that's just how my mind works, and I love it. So I'm on day 3 of a fast. I got 4 days left. I'm using a lymphatic herb. I'm using herbs for the liver. I'm using ginkgo, which, like I said, is good for the heart, circulation, anxiety, full of antioxidants, so many things. And I'm essentially just drinking water. So I'm gonna make me another thing of tea. I hope you all enjoyed the video. I definitely appreciate you and your time. Leave me a comment, please. Share this with someone who you think would want to sit here for however long I just sat here and did this video for. Give the video a thumbs up if you want, and subscribe, because I would love to have you as a subscriber while I'm on this journey of health and vitality and life, you know, with raw foods and, you know, plant-based living. I would definitely love to have you as a subscriber. And like I said, leave a comment, like the video, because that really helps the channel to grow. It helps YouTube, because when YouTube sees, you know, oh, people are liking this video and they're commenting, you know, they're interacting, they're like, oh, hey, well, we're gonna push it up in the algorithm, right? We're gonna make it easier for people to find this video. So definitely that would help me out greatly, and I appreciate you. Peace be with you, and I will see y'all in the next video.